when I came here, I knew for myself that if I need to search my way into the subject of war, I would be doing something with the financial crisis, because I have the feeling that the financial crisis is a front that's in our history for a long time, and somehow all the battles we are fighting are related to Schulden, wie man das in Deutsch sagt. So I knew this would be somehow a starting point, but I really tried not to bring anything from home to the camp. So I was really like a white paper. I came here and started on the first day with looking to what the other writers were doing and what the other actors were doing, and try to relate on it. Like, what's the way? What can I tribute to what's already going on? And so the first thing I did, I wrote a little scene called a Fetzen, about an Indian who is coming to the front and is searching for the front, the Millennium field, and finds no front. And so this was for me the first, how do you say it, Versuch om to get into the subject. And it was quite funny to use an Indian and the people who are walking around here with their dogs shitting on the Millennium field. And then after that, I came more clear for me that I should go in another direction. And then I was thinking about the diaries. If you have all the wars in the world, there's always some soldiers who write their memories down. In I thought that this could be also a way to describe the front. And then I thought, like, okay, but then when I want to talk about the financial front, it's quite difficult to write it in a diary. And then I thought, like, well, maybe then it's a good idea that I take the situation, the reality of the situation of the camp, with the actors and the writers and the technique, and that it's a setting, and they are somehow a front or soldiers, and I will describe at one hand what the process is going on in the camp, and I try to achieve to the financial crisis to put it in the thoughts of somebody who's riding there. And of course, you have only 1 week, so on that moment you have to start writing, and you have to produce something, because the work we make is the process we're in is that if you have an idea, you have till, let's say, the morning, then till 1 o'clock to produce text, and then you want to have translated, and it will take 1 or 2 hours. Then you have to give it to Frank to make something out of it this night. So from then on, I was really in this process of producing these diaries every day and give it to Frank so he could play with it at night. So this was the work I did.
Twee kampen. Het kamp van de crediteuren en het kamp van de debiteuren. Schuldeisers en schuldenaren. En de inzet van de strijd is meer schuld. Maak meer schuld.
Es gibt nur eine Front, einen Kampf, zwei Lager. Das Lager der Kreditnehmer und das Lager der Kreditgeber, Gläubiger und Schuldner. Der Einsatz in diesem Kampf, mehr Schulden. Macht mehr Schulden.
I get inspired by the people I work with and the talks we have, and so I'm all the time, let's say, like a tape recorder, I'm taping what's happening around me. So this is what I like. If I would choose the form that I would write about this theater group on the Millennium Field doing this project, it would be somehow to be too narrow for me, so there's no artistic touch in it. So I try to use the process of the people in the camp and then keep away a little bit the theater. So I will not talk about actors, I will not talk about writers, maybe I will talk about kameraden. I will talk about that they are doing their preparation, but I will not say that they will do the preparation for a show. So I try to keep this in the middle somehow. And if you take the theater part out, then of course, the nice thing about being here at the Millennium Field, with the situation we have, it looks then like a real camp for war.
Tag 6. Ich lag wieder die ganze Nacht wach. Zwei Hubschrauber kreisten über dem Camp. Als sie näher kamen, klang es, als stünde neben meinem Zelt ein Lautsprecher, bei dem die Höhen heruntergeregelt wurden. Die Tiefen ließen den Boden, das Zelt, den Tisch vibrieren. Alles vibrierte. Meine Hände, meine Beine, meine Flasche Aftershave.
Ondanks de opklaringen overdag voelt alles 's nachts klam. Klam en koud. Toen ik mijn bed verliet om naar de latrine te gaan, trof ik op de appelplaats een kameraad.
And of course I was also talking or writing a little bit from my alter ego then, because I wanted to create somebody who was having these doubts all the time and saying all the time to himself like words that's marching in his head. Es gibt nur ein Front, ein Kampf, zwei Lager. This must be all the time in his head, and he has to find his way through his thoughts how to explain this for to himself. And it's connecting to my own thoughts, but of course it's much more in an artist way written down. What I know is that this person who's writing, suffering from that he cannot sleep. So his images will be every day a little bit more strange. And this I took also from the real situation that, I mean, the first night I couldn't sleep. There were ants running around my bed, around my head. And I felt like, okay, if this would be the situation for a few weeks, I would be insane. So you have to use the, you can use this for this people, or this alter ego, who's getting nuts a little bit. And by, yeah, good talk to here. Yeah.